Today, I'm going to show you how to anchor properly, how to anchor without losing your back tension, and also the proper position to be in for a solid anchor.
You're watching the Jake Kaminsky YouTube channel.
If you're new here, my name is Jake Kaminsky. I'm an Olympic silver medalist 2 times in the sport of archery, and I train full-time under Coach Lee, which is the method that I'm going to be showing you in these videos throughout this entire series. There's a form series and a tuning series. I'll put a link in the description below. I'll put a card at the top as well to show you where you can find the rest of the playlist for this series as well. So question of the day. Today, I'm going to post it below in the comment section, and I'd appreciate a reply because I'm curious. What did you learn today after watching the full video that you never heard before? Or was there something explained to you in a way that made sense and it finally clicked?
So how do we move from load position to anchor without losing our back tension? It's super simple. It's really not that complicated. Before, I've already shown you how to move your arms independent of your shoulders. Well, you can also move your hand independent of your entire back half. You can also anchor without losing your back tension as well. So it's going to be a little difficult, but the best way that I can show you is by facing the other way, and I'll show you where my scapula is with this finger. So you'll see on this side, the tip of my scapula is right here. As I come from setup into loading, you'll see my scapula move closer to my spine, right? So as I load, I'm only a half inch below my jaw, and I can anchor correctly. And you'll actually see my scapula probably move a little bit closer to my spine. Or I can load and then anchor incorrectly. And you'll see how now my scapula is here. So incorrectly is this, correctly is this. So all that you do is you hit load about a half inch below your jaw, give or take, and then just move your hand up into anchor. And as you're moving, you can almost do this type of motion, load, anchor, load, anchor. So it's just a rotation of the arm. It's not anchor like this, because if you anchor with your elbow going up as a driving force, that's where this gets lost. So if my elbow doesn't move up and I just rotate, it doesn't lose my back tension. But load, anchor, I lose my back tension. Obviously, that's a bit exaggerated, but you get the point.
Good, strong shot, Nick. Good, strong shot, Nick.
Now, where do we load? We actually load with this knuckle, and optimally, we do not use a shelf. Some people have used shelves. I've used a shelf in the past. It's definitely not as consistent as bone to bone because, you know, you can have different amounts of contact with a object that is not part of your body to feel how much pressure you're pushing into it, especially because you have one and two sources of information of how much pressure you're pushing into your anchor. And the more sources you have, the more consistent you can be in theory with your anchor. So ideally where we anchor is the top of this knuckle. If I take a pen, let's see where I have one. So where you want to anchor is the top of this knuckle. If I were to take a marker and show you where the center of my pressure on my hand is, it's going to be right about there. So the absolute top of my knuckle, right there, not over here and not in here. So I'm not anchoring here because then my dot's not under my jaw, and I'm also not twisting my hand or anchoring further under than I need to as well. That's where we put pressure on our hand, but where do we put pressure on our jaw? Our pressure upward into our anchor is just straight up into the bottom of our jawbone. It's not under in the meat, and it's not hanging out. bear bows, you know, you guys will be in the corner of your mouth or something like that. And when I shoot bear bow, that's where I'm going to be as well. That's where I shoot traditional too. I start kids off that way because it's just easier for them to put their finger in the corner of their mouth as opposed to trying to get into proper anchor. It just throws everybody for a loop. So you know how to move up into anchor, you know where to anchor. Now, how much pressure do you anchor with? This is something that a lot of people don't think about or look over. It should be very tight. So the best way that I can illustrate it is by showing you on my fingers how I'm squeezing my anchor. So I can touch my fingers together, or I can touch the bones of my fingers together. So as the blood flow comes back, so right now I have skin contact, but I can crush up and down how much I'm actually anchoring. And unless you're bone to bone, you have a inconsistency in your anchor. So you need to push really hard up into your anchor, and your jaw has to be closed as well. Many people I see, especially beginners, they will pull the bow back and then shift their jaw or open their mouth to get towards anchor because they can't get into position properly. Never, ever open your mouth while you're shooting. Why? Because as you're opening your mouth, your rear sight height, yeah, we don't have a peep sight on a recurve, so it's a little bit difficult to see the rear sight picture change, but just watch the distance from where my arrow would be to my eye change as I go from my mouth closed to my mouth open. You see my hand move down, so that means it's changing my impact point dramatically. Never ever shoot with your mouth open. Your teeth have to be touching while you're at full draw. Not only is there pressure going up into your anchor, but there's also string pressure coming against your face. You should be pulling the string hard against your chin and hard against your nose. If you watch a lot of the top Korean shooters, especially the women, they have a permanent line in their face because they shoot so many arrows, but also how hard they pull into their face. It acts as an extra anchor point, not only up into your jaw, but also back with the string. So now your draw length doesn't want to change as you're shaking, or because you're anchored so solidly, you will be shaking much, much less. The harder I anchored, the less I shook, the better everything got, especially under pressure. So hard pull against your face, hard push up into your face as, or into your jaw as well, but also in as well. If I had to draw a line in the angle that my pressure was going up into my jaw with anchor, it would not be straight up. It would actually be in a little bit. So not straight up, but in a little bit. So I'm going up and also in as well because I'm pulling around as well. I'm using this part of my face as a hinge for this part of my body to rotate around and behind me. And that's really facilitating lots of back tension and very, very little arm tension. As I'm anchoring, I'm not changing my bow arm position at all in space. I'm not changing where my eyes are. I'm not turning my head. I'm not moving my head towards my anchor. None of that. You have to stay completely centered. Your head has to be over your neck, over your spine, over the ground. Nothing changes. Nothing moves. All that moves is your hand up into anchor. That's it. Now, if you remember in set position when we talked about the proper hook, we have this type of position with our hand, right? So we have this open spot. There's no gap. There's a big gap there. So where do we put this? So this thumb has to be tucked down and back, right? But as we're anchoring, you have this muscle. It's called the SCM, the sternoclinomastoid, if I remember correctly. And you have to be either in front of it or behind it with your thumb. Now, only people with either large hands or smaller heads really can get their thumb behind their SCM. So here is behind the SCM, and here is in front of the SCM. So I'm one of those unfortunate people that can't get it behind. I believe it will have a little bit cleaner of a release if you can get into that position. However, I'd say less than 10% of the people that I've ever worked with can get behind their SCM. So for me, I'm in front of my SCM, and unfortunately, once you're in this position and how strong and how hard you're pushing into your anchor and also the pressure going in because you're using it as a hinge around your back, you're going to feel like you're choking. I 100% gagged the first time I anchored properly according to Coach Lee. I couldn't get a shot off for a couple shots because I was gagging as I was choking myself. So literally I come in loading and then into anchor, and I'm pushing really hard into my esophagus inward to try to get buried in there and get this knuckle underneath my jaw. Unfortunately, my SCM has become so developed from constantly turning my head one direction because I'm shooting this way. So I don't know if it's still big anymore. I haven't shot in a very long time, but this side was much bigger than this side. And now they feel pretty even. It's not as developed over here. But it used to be so developed that I had a really hard time getting into anchor. And there was a kind of a trade-off that I had to come up with, where the more you can turn your head, the better the string alignment you can get into while being in a natural type of position without tilting your head a whole lot. So I was having trouble at one point with string alignment, only because I wasn't turning my head as much, because the more you turn your head, the bigger the SCM gets, or the harder it gets, basically. So what I've learned to do as a compromise, instead of choking myself to death, is that I didn't turn my head as hard as much, and then I crushed the SCM down as I come into anchor. So again, it's even tightening my anchor even more. There's more contact in this area, so it's more and more stable every single time you add more pressure into the anchor. Well, quick recap. Again, to go from loading to anchor, you just move your hand straight up. You use the top of this knuckle, the direct bottom of your jaw. You go bone to bone contact. You have pressure up, in, and back against your face. And then you have to choose whether you go in front of or behind your SCM. It's that simple.
Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you get notified every time a new video is uploaded. For seminar and book info, head to jkaminsky.com or click on the link below. And I appreciate you guys watching. If you would, please share this video. It'd really help get the word back out that I am back out there. Thanks again. Take care.